Well, hello and welcome to this week's Dividend Cafe. A very different week this week than last week. We obviously are still kind of in the aftermath of this first breaking of volatility. We had not had such an experience in quite a long time, as you know. And last week having such a significant and accelerated what we call panic attack in the market has sort of created a different theme and mood and paradigm, if you will. And so then this week now, market as of right now, I'm recording the middle of Thursday, the Dow is up 75 points. If it closes up today, it'd be 5 days in a row of positive movement, some of which are substantial. So, you know, we're back to a position where the market is still down from where it was at its high. It's roughly 1,000 points off of its low. And it is up on the year. We're up over 1% as of this moment in which I'm talking in both the Dow and the S&P for 2018. So who knows? That could be different by the end of the day. It could be different by end of the month. You know the drill. I won't spend a lot of time talking about the market volatility stuff today because I want to spend a lot of time on the subject of inflation. Because the kind of key, regardless of the fact, I think we've all established now that you had sort of a structural and mechanical and, if you will, technical driver of market complexity volatility last week. It was exacerbated by structural and technical factors. But that doesn't change the fact that the fundamental kind of initial domino, if you will, is this sort of belief, and I think it is somewhat fundamental and potentially perpetual, that the risk of inflation and inflation expectations coming higher would represent a natural compression to market volatility, to market valuation. And I think that's a fair way to approach it. And I also think that I spent a little time writing about this week. I spent even more time thinking about it. That there is a need to kind of respect the potential of a paradigmatic shift, not necessarily the markets were up and now they're down and they were down and now they're up, but I mean, the framing of risk and reward as a stock market investor from a deflationary and low growth environment to a potentially non-deflationary and high growth environment, or even an inflationary environment, which is potentially different. I don't believe we have any evidence yet at all that we are entering an inflationary environment. I certainly believe it's possible. And I do believe that that would represent a kind of repricing of assets and a shift in leadership in risk assets. What assets would be expected to perform best in an inflationary context would be different than the environment we've been in. High PE stocks will not do well in an inflationary environment. That high multiple has to come down. So these types of considerations on a macro basis for longer term, not for a trade, not for a week, not for a month, but as far as entering an actual potential new kind of era of leadership and risk assets would be something that we take very seriously. But as far as the kind of just basic level of, hey, inflation has been lacking and now all of a sudden it's coming in droves because wages last month reflected a 2.9% increase year over year. I will tell you that the notion that that wage growth creates inflation is wrong. I mean, I would call it much more inflammatory things, but I'm in a pretty good mood. The reality is that inflation is caused as a monetary phenomena when there is an acceleration in growth of money supply and an inadequate level of goods and services in the economy to soak up that money supply. The growth of goods and services keeping pace with growth of money supply means that there's not inflation. Well, the growth of money supply has been highly, highly compressed over the last several years. There's been very little velocity of money, been a lower demand for money. And that's one of the big things I've talked about ad nauseum over the last 10 years as to why so many people I sarcastically call the inflationistas got quantitative easing so wrong. They believed that the Fed was adding to money supply when in reality them printing that money and putting it at bank reserves was doing no such thing. It was not money in circulation in the economy. They had a different motive for doing it, and I have a different criticism for it, but it wasn't increasing money supply in and of itself. So to the extent that people in the press will now report that wage growth means higher inflation, they're wrong. Now, could we be going down a path to higher inflation? I believe it's always possible, but it will be a monetary phenomena if and when it happens. Business owners paying more for wages could be a byproduct of a labor shortage. It could be a byproduct of competitiveness. It could be a byproduct of changing in the global environment. It could be all sorts of technological. There's so much complexity around how these things get priced in a marketplace that us sitting around saying, oh, inflation's coming because wages went higher, so let's buy this stock or sell this stock. It's silly, so we're not going to do it. It's wrong on the macroeconomic front and even more wrong in the execution. So to our degree, the kind of takeaways of this week is that we do believe that we want to very consciously and intentionally study the paradigm the market's been in and where it is headed, and make sure that we're aligning client portfolios and risk-reward expectations accordingly. And then in terms of this actual volatility spurt of last week, it doesn't feel like the same angst is there. We think it could come back at any time. And as I said, and I mean from the bottom of my heart, I view it as a pretty healthy thing for investors to be aware of the fact that markets create volatility. Read dividendcafe.com this week, some incredible charts about the way markets generally respond out of such spurts. Incredible chart about the norm of intra-year downside volatility, and you can look at it year over year and how positive years still create intra-year volatility, what that normally looks like. A lot of other things too about inflation, about, you know, markets. So dividendcafe.com, reach out anytime with questions for us. And then definitely if you're a podcast listener, check out Advice and Insights podcast this week. Did a lengthy Q&A on different things that came in from listeners, and I think there's a lot of compelling stuff there. It'll give you a chance to kind of get to know Bahnsen Group a little better. Okay, that's our story for the week. I'm going back to work. It's great to see you all, hear you all, and I will close with this because there aren't adequate words, but it's important I say it. The tragedy in Florida last night being reported, just unspeakable. And the only thing I can say is our hearts, thoughts, prayers are with the victims and the people directly affected and the community at large there. Just an absolute awful moral atrocity. We're heartbroken as our whole country is. Okay. Thanks for listening, Dividend Cafe.